Hey everyone, Melcadrien here. We're back with more Rogue Legacy. Let's see, what do we have for... You know what, let's re-roll, see if we can get a miner. Apparently we can't. We do have a spell sword. Not exactly a good one because of a blade wall. Let's try out this mist form. And before we do anything, we're gonna buy some new stuff. A sky sword. Nice. I'm getting rid of that. Sage equipment. In a moment, though. Because... it's really heavy, for one. It's not really doing any good after... anyways. Let's just put on the blood cape again. I mean, it's doing the job right. It's doing its job. There we go. Now let's look at the runes. We are one away from the whole collection, guys. One away. That really is a whole lot. Just one away. Oh, one thing I could do is boost the gold gain. There we go. Now we'll get a little bit more gold. Yes. Let me through. Come on. Alright. It's time to hunt for some more money. The hunt for money. 14 gold. Can't see in 3D. It's like Paper Rogue Legacy. Why? Because look at it. He's paper. He's only one dimension. He's a flat surface. It must be that it's Paper Mario-like. It's a paper game. Ow. So, what does the old mist form do anyways? Never actually tried it out, so this is gonna be a maiden voyage for us. Maybe we'll actually find out if it actually lets us pass through certain walls. Like the replacement technique can't. Or maybe those sorts of rooms, the ones there where there's no way in to get the enemies, requires the crows of all... For whatever reason. Which is very interesting. And we got Hyperion's Ring. Which means we can stand one hit, one death. We can actually see how much it restores. Defeat all enemies. Nope. Did nothing. Well... can't go through walls, so that means, well, it means that it doesn't really have any real use, except for avoiding hits, I guess, and I don't see that going on being used a whole lot. All that laughter. Bounty! And that's the last of the runes. So, what will we get after we've collected all the runes? I have no idea. Take this, and this, and that, and this. Alright, which way to go, which way to go? Okay. Ooh, I almost took a hit. But then again, taking a hit in Hamson really isn't that much of a drawback. Alright. More money. More money. Oh. Another shrine. I'm not gonna replace Hyperion's ring yet. Because we still have uses for it. I have big plans for you. More sandwich. What? You would think I was gonna give more pain? No. Seriously. Who wants to bring pain to a picnic? You wanna bring more sandwiches. And I'm wasting all my food. Good move, self. They're just all in the way. All right. I hope there wasn't any other money in here. Else I would have lost it. Haha! I got it all! I got it all! More money. I wonder if I'll be able to clear out this section before I die. It would be certainly interesting though. Oh. Bad horse. You're leaving fire all over the place. Ow. Yay! And it only restores part of my health. Ow! I tried to jump down, but I jumped up. Well, let's try one more. Quantum Translocator drops and teleports to your shadow. Nah. The Spelunket. Actually, this one would actually be useful. Let's take it. And... let's see. Let us... boost our attack and our mana. Alright. Round two. It's treasure time. $170 gold. And knowing where all the treasure is a nice thing. Alright. Big bad guy. It helps a lot. All right. Plonk that. Plonky. Plonk. Plonk is a nice game. I never actually truly played it, but I saw the gameplay of it and it's such nostalgia. Nothing up here, except free gold! If I ever find any nerd's glasses, you can very well bet that I'm gonna try that out. I heard that the glasses actually does something. That's all the enemies. Let's see what we get inside the chest. Stat boosts. Okay, I'll take it. Wait. I think I found your older brother. Or maybe your twin brother. There are two of them. But which one's the real one? Of course they're both real, but it's kind of funny. Two times. Alright. Found the boss room. And money. Alright. Is there anywhere else to go? Yes, to the right. Defeat all enemies. Can't do it with this. All clear. And we get more health. More health. Every little bit counts, my friends. Every little bit counts. Towards us being super powerful. Super powerful. Super powerful, yeah! Why do they call those monsters rage? I mean, are they raging against something? Their machine? Bad guys? The fact that they're so angry. We are so angry! We are not the main characters, so we are so angry about it. Eyes go first. The eyes got it. There's a treasure over there. And we want treasure. Because we need upgrades. It's that way. Well, let's look over here. Well, there's a boss door right next to us, which means money. Every time we find a boss door, it's free money. Defeat all enemies. So many enemies. So much to clear. All clear. And we get some armor boosts. Hulk, stand here, take hits like a big wimp. I should be hitting you, but I don't have a sword. I suck. It has a weird moving pattern. It's so hard to figure out which way it's going. Let's go this way. Ding, 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 level up, ding, level up. It's like rubber banding of a sort. Except you're not exactly rubber banding, because this isn't a video game and... Well, actually, it is a video game. It's the fact that you're not online. Because that's what rubber banding is. And I've seen a lot of it in my day. Namely, Matrix Online. You see a lot of rubber banding in that game, believe me. You trying to mimic your way out of this? Guess what? I want the gold inside you.
Not the gold! Please don't kill us! Don't give me the gold, just don't kill us!
Ow. This way! To glory! And gold! Mostly gold, because... Because gold. We need all that money to get the best stuff. Called the best stuff. Probably would help if I got some more health, though. I'm better off just whacking at the shield. Come on. It arcs in such a way that is so weird. You can just stay there, portrait. I'm gonna let you live. Oop. Not going up there. No, sorry. There is something over here. And I, in the middle of it, well, in the middle, Good thing I have no foot pulse. Right, those traps require a pulse. That's actually a bit of a problem. If someone doesn't have a pulse on the legs, that really makes things a bit difficult if I were to actually use those as traps in my castle, because what if they kill the pulse in their legs? Sure, they wouldn't feel anything in their feet, but it's still no foot pulse. Ow. Ow. Time to get back to the castle proper. For now anyways, because we need food. Okay, sorry about that. Got distracted. Where was I? Alright. Boss room. And over here. Don't have enough health, so I'd rather go through the main castle and get some more blood. If they don't do clever stuff like this. Alright. Woo! Dodge that. All right. This way. Treasures are downward. I think it shows every enemy position, even though we haven't seen where they are. Now, it doesn't seem to show those that have spontaneously spawned another, like those spinning balls of death. Oh, needs dwarfism. Well, that stinks. These eyes. The eyes have it, but I'm getting rid of all of them. There we go. All cleared. Now the eyes no longer have it. It's all the nays. Ah, 9,000 gold. 9,000 pieces of gold on the wall, 9,000 pieces of gold! Take one down, pass it around, then get it right back because I want you to bring it back to me. You nasty little thief. I want that money. Let's see, still a whole forest to go through. Go away, go away, go away, go away, go away. Alright, back into the, castle. They say it's decorative, but it actually has a use. It really has a use. It lights up that dungeon. Who knew that having a lantern actually helps? Forget that piece of gold. Forget that. I would rather get more gold than just try and sacrifice more health just trying to get it. Ow. Bad skeleton archer? trying to hit me in the right spot. You can't have accuracy. The only one who's supposed to have accuracy is me. Me. Your king and ruler. Alright, what do we have down here? I have fury! And I have killed them all. Alright, let's go up here, there's treasure. Cleaned, except for the corners. Gotta get those corners. Ah. He's not so tall. In fact, he is so tiny. It is so tiny. Another shrine. And we got Charon's oval. Charon's. Anyways. This way. Oh. It's next door. It's like having a neighbor. Hello, it's your neighbor, the forest. We would like you to please stop burning down the forest. Because as you well know, only you can prevent forest fires. Send a few thieves flying. Because why not? Helps clear the room a bit. Money. Alright. Going down. Alright. Flower Mon. Hey Mon, I'm a flower. I'm gonna kill ya. Because feed me, Seymour. Little shop of horrors. Now that would be an interesting thought. A gallery of horrors. There would be a lot. So many of them, and I wasted a whole lot of magic doing that. Oh well. Let's see. More forest up there. Is there anything? The boss door is right there. Should I risk it? Might as well. We may get some money out of it. Ah! Just die already. Well, I took one hit, and that's all I'm gonna take. Because I am hurt. Alright. Let's go right. Because there's a lot more stuff that way. Actually, there's stuff up here as well, so let's head up. And this horse ran right into me. Okay. Whoa. Can I make it to the bottom? Yes, I can. Can we do it? Yes, we can. These baddies are usually easy to kill anyways. And they have good money too. It's over here. A room of death. I generally hate this sort of room because there's spikes all over the place, and one wrong move means, well, you take a good bit of damage for one, and if you're low on health, you're pretty much dead. Stop that! Stupid dog. You make me look bad. Booga booga booga. Alright. Up. Made it, ran it. Yes, people's tongues get tied every time. So don't discount mine. Yeah, that dog made a mad dash for me. Such a good dog. But he didn't fetch me my paper. So for that, he had to die. And I think he was already rabid, so there's that too. $20,000 gold. Man, we are in the money. And some of that's actually gonna go upgrade my money gains. Because the more money we get, the better we're off. And that way we can boost our own power. Power boost! Ow. What the? Nightmare. Oh. That skeleton was trying to hide out from us. Didn't work so much, now did it? And now we have more health. A drinking fountain? Don't really need that. Ow. You know what? Might as well use it. 63. A little bit wasted, but... oh well. Got some MP back, which is a good thing. Looks like we've got the whole forest taken care of. Got the whole forest taken care of, so... it's time to get out of here. Just make sure we don't fall into the void, like that guy that was just flying in the background. Alright. There's the exit. Not this way, though. Absolutely not. Alright. Let's go this way. Another shrine. You're not. Let's change out Karin's Oval with Hyperion's Ring. Why not? Planite. Is that what it is? Planite? This way. This away. Oh. Justify. Apparently it restores only a fourth of our health. Which is kinda okay. There's only one chest up there. May as well not go for it. It'll take too long. So, let us delve into the Land of Darkness. Because why not? It's the only place left. Gotta be careful. Oh, they're trapped in there. Okay, but their sword isn't. Their sword is not blocked by the wall. Big sword. Ouch. That's a lot of kills, though. That's a lot of money. And I'm probably going to be using that to buff something important. Well, making sure that I buff the money gain, because, well, more money, more buffs. But that's the end of this episode of Rogue Legacy, so until next time, this is Melcadrien, I'm signing off. Have a great day, guys, and happy gaming!